Hi everyone, welcome back to the Prophecies of Victor the Budgie, where you can hear Budgies communicating in full-blown speech, channeling hidden messages from the angels. This channel now includes Maylor and Danny, which were two other Budgies who I was a guardian for as well. Hi everyone, this is Ryan, and I'm back with another incredible communication from the angels that you won't believe. It's one of Maylor's clearest recordings, and I recorded it only a couple weeks after I got him on March 5th, 2010. I've talked about Maylor before, but surely one of the most amazing things about him was that he started talking and recording within a day of him arriving at my place. It was evident almost immediately that he had a purpose, and he knew we were destined to be with each other. He actually told me what his name was and said he wanted to help. Later, I'll provide you with some of his earliest recordings when he told me he wanted to help. This is only an audio recording because I had not started using the camera with him yet. Nonetheless, this is an exceptional recording that shows how intelligent he was, even when the person who gave him to me said he didn't talk much. I did the original translation of this while I was at Shoulders Hospital while getting two large hernias repaired on my stomach. At the time, I was working at a very labor-intensive job and split my stomach in two places where I had previous operations. Luckily, I had insurance and could afford to go to one of the best hospitals in the world for that type of injury. Before I left for the operation, I recorded Maylor on my digital audio recorder and brought my computer with me to the hospital. The next day, after the operation, barely able to get out of bed, I did the translation right there. You can imagine what it was like after my operation to have my spirits lifted as I translated this recording. So even before my operation, he talks about how I had been working too hard and how the injuries were causing me suffering. He also says that we, he and the angels, know that my stitches hurt and how his recordings are different than other Budgies who mimic, because he can comment in real time while I do the transcription. Maylor also talks about me having a vacation, which I needed at the time. He tries to lift my spirits and talks about pretending that I'm a pontiff on a vacation and the angels are making me a formal pontiff suit, which was quite a beautiful thing to say at the time. This is one recording that I will definitely never forget and hope you will enjoy it too. So this is a forward part, and Maylor says, "I'm getting better speech. They'll laugh at this. I'm your Budgie and your coach, like you be. I'll be your favorite. A lot of people speak of this. So let people speak, yeah. In your current employment, tis, 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 we see, Ryan, you've been working very hard, causing you some hernias. The things I know cannot compare to Budgie speaking. I can comment on transcripts as you're working right now. It makes you happy, eh? Ryan, you must stop because you hurt and you'll feel better. Hey, lover boy, we know that your stitches hurt. Your long vacation is coming. It's good for you even if you fool around. Let's pretend you're better and we know you can rescue people and Ryan is a pontiff. The angels will make you a suit formally and there's a miracle waiting."
Thank you.
There's one thing I learned in this recording is that the angels have a sense of humor and imagination, and will often use it when trying to encourage someone. Another interesting thing is that all three of my budgies have come up with multiple words that I had to look up in the dictionary, often finding that they could not have used a better word to describe what they were talking about. For instance, I have heard the word pontiff before and knew it had a religious meaning. But when I looked it up, it said it could mean a Roman Catholic Pope, the Bishop of Rome, or any high or chief priest. I remember one time that another budgie, who I was translating for a friend, called me a holy man in reverse. I found that quite remarkable as well. In the reverse of this, Maylor uses the word summon, and I know what that means, but wanted a clear explanation of it. When I looked it up, it said, to call together, convene, summon a meeting of officials. It seems that no matter what budgie recording I use, they are always current and talking about things that are happening right now. That is the difference between a religion that has a living God and one you just learn about from books. So you really cannot deny that at the time I'm doing the recording, the connection is live with the angels and they are passing on real-time information, even when the recordings were done 10 or 20 years ago. The reverse of this is quite clear as well, and I'm not going to get into any more explanations because most of it is self-explanatory. However, I will mention that there was a prophecy prior to this that said this religion would start to gain momentum by the summertime. So I think someone asked a question about it and Maylor answered them. Let's go back for a second to what he said in the forward mode at the very end. He said, let's pretend you're better and we now can rescue people and Ryan is a pontiff and the angels will make you a suit formally and then in the reverse and there is a miracle waiting. There'll be some progress developing when spiritual people are summoned, for ahead is a religion that responds to a world in which a prophet and the angels in heaven is your family. Help is part of the reality that we're all living in. Can we bring the courageous by summer? There are some people we are waiting for that will be helping us. We answered questions and watched these friendly people who will soon declare that they are happy this is something they can listen to during a developing religion. And they all have prophecy that arrives with summer of the angels. Such a gift is something to treasure and give forever. When we give prophecy, it's bound to form with the coming of a spiritual family here. So now let's hear that reverse. The last thing I'm going to do in this presentation is play one of Maylor's, which I believe could have been his first recording, a day or two after he arrived. It is only 2 minutes long, but he says quite a bit. The name his previous guardian had given him was Lucky, when he landed on her shoulder one day when she was in her garden, only a few doors down from where I was. So here you can see that I recorded this on February 21st, 2010. It's called Lucky Maylor, Lucky Me. So when I did this video in February 21st, 2010, I made some comments at the end of the video, and it said, I first met this budgie about 1 year ago. When I saw it in the cage, it was suffering badly. I told the owner it had mites and needed immediate attention. She took it to the vet and it got treatment. The mites went away and the budgie got healthy again. In the next frame, I said, today the owner asked me if I would take the budgie. One day it flew on her shoulder, as it must have flew away from its home. So she really did not plan to have it. I told her I'd be glad to take it, and that was February 21st, the same day. Next I said, my other budgies are in their own room. I knew I had to isolate him first for 6 weeks before I brought him into the room. So I decided to work with him on his own, and I moved my computer into a separate room just for him. And then in the final part of the video, I said, once I got my computer set up, I introduced him to about 30 minutes of Victor's recordings. Shortly after that, I was surprised to hear him talking clearly. This was the first recording I made of him only about 4 hours after I received him. So it was a lot sooner than I thought or remembered. So I guess the question I have to ask God and the angels too is, will it begin to happen this summer? Because it seems awful lonely here without anyone saying anything. I shouldn't complain though. Moses and the Israelites walked the desert and searched for the promised land for 40 years, and I've only been doing this for about 20. Whenever it happens, it will be fine with me, even if it happens after I die. Only God and the angels know when the time is right and when to summon his spiritual people who will finally embrace this as a new religion they can be proud of. This completes this presentation. Thanks for listening. If you'd like to join us, you can come to theangelscrolls.com and click on to the forum link at the top, where we will be adding the newest presentations. Bye for now.